Hey gun people, wanted to do a little video on deploying smoke. I found these little smoke grenades. They sell them for the paintballs. This happens to be, I'm thinking it's yellow because it's got the yellow on here. I think they cost $4 or $5 each. You can get them at the paintball store. In the military, we used to have smoke that we could throw, but it's very hard to get that kind. So I don't know how my horses are going to react to this, but I'm going to go ahead and pull this little wire. Supposedly they're cold burning, and we'll see what happens. See if this sucker lights or not. And I want to talk about deploying the smoke and how smoke goes off. So let me go out there and toss this. The wind should be going this way. When you deploy smoke, you want to throw it upwind so the wind blows the area. So if I wanted to cover this horse area with some smoke, I'm going to throw this to the left so the smoke will blow across the area that I either want to block them from seeing me, or I want to make sure that we can move, etc., without being seen. So I'm going to come out here and throw this smoke out here, see if it works. Hey, the horses don't like it. They're out of there. And as you can tell, if I was trying to see in that horse pen, now I can't, because that smoke is creating a cloud and I've got a good wind, so it's staying low to the ground. So this would be giving me pretty good cover. I don't know how long it blows. Doesn't burn that long, but enough. If I had two or three of those to throw, it would give me enough. Buddy's like, dude, what are you doing? Mr. T's like, I don't care what he's doing. I'm getting out of here. I'm just going to walk away because I don't need any problems. So that's what a smoke grenade did. And again, it's you're okay, buddy. It's got a little pin that you just kind of pull out. It ignites, you pull it to the side. It's got a cap. That one, I think, is supposedly 20,000 cubic feet. I'll put the specs in the description on what that is. They sell bigger or smaller ones. I also put a link to where I bought them. If you're a prepper, or if you just want to be prepared for anything, I mean, having smoke's kind of a good deal. If you want to scare your horses with it, you can do that. If you want to signal something, if somebody was hurt in a helicopter or somebody was trying to find you, you can pull one of these smokes. In the military, we'll use smoke to either cover movement, or we'll use it for signals on either to come get us, or we're safe, or it's a good landing zone, or a marked landing zone. So there's all kind of uses for smoke. And the wind's blowing out here pretty heavy, so if you want to complain about it, I wanted to pick a windy day for the smoke, because the heavier the wind, the lower the smoke's going to go. If there's no wind, your smoke usually just dissipates and goes straight up and spreads, so it doesn't give you a lot of cover. So depending on where you want to cover, you have to do the wind. And normally the way I do my wind is I just pick up some grass and drop it. So I know my wind's going this way. So if I want to cover this area, because I know the wind and the speed, I'm going to deploy my smoke this way. So as the smoke gets bigger, it gives me cover here. And again, if I wanted to move from building to building, there was somebody with a sniper, and we had to move from one area to the other, you throw smoke, it covers it, so that covers your movement, so you can get guys across this danger area, or this danger zone, and you cover it with smoke. It also prevents you to move in different positions if they know where you're at, and they've got you pinned down. If you throw smoke, you can relocate, and then they have to find you again. They don't know where you went or where you dug in. So you can use it for distracting. If I want to throw smoke here, normally most people will see smoke and they will look. So if I want to move over here and I have multiple troops or forces in different areas, I may say, look, I'm ready to move, but I don't want this guy looking my way when I move, so I want you to pop a smoke. That's going to bring all the enemy's attention to you, which is going to allow me to move. Even though I'm not using the smoke, it's going to allow me to move and get forward or go where I need to go to complete my mission, whatever. So smokes, the military uses for a reason. It's good. Again, signaling. This place had the little Coast Guard, the orange smoke. I bought some white smoke. I bought some green, yellow, and red. And I'm going to keep it in my bug out bag. I may keep one or two in the car. Again, you know, there's an accident. You get stuck somewhere. You need to signal. You hear a plane. You can pop one of these and the plane's going to be flying and they're going to see it. So I think it's a good thing to have. If you want to invest to save it, if you're planning for the big one or shit at the fan, I definitely think you want to have some smoke. It's going to help you in a crisis if you're moving, distraction. If you pop one in a house or a building, you're definitely going to disorient people. You're going to cause some sort of panic. You're going to gain the advantage when you have smoke. So if I had a choice of having smoke and not having smoke, I always had smoke. Okay, hope that helps on a little smoke deployment there. My horses are mad at me now. Like, dude, we were relaxing in our area. You come out with your damn toys and shit scaring us. Buddy, Mr. T, you're good boys. They're like, whatever, dude. Go take your smoke and play somewhere else.